When you hear labeling, you need to be more intelligent than the label. You need to rise above it and tell yourself, whatever good is coming from this person, I will take it. Whatever bad is coming, I will discount it. The reason is, even if you belong to one group, it does not mean the ustazas of your group, everything they say is right. They will also say wrong things. You will have to pick it up. And it doesn't mean that there is a Christian across the road, so they cannot teach you something good. I have had people who taught me mathematics and geography and biology and sociology and English language who were Jews and Christians and Hindus and people who belong to other faiths. I took from them whatever I had to and I left whatever I didn't.
And as for this statement, leave the good, take the good and leave the evil, this opposes the ijma of the Salaf, the complete consensus of the great imams of the Salaf. Without a shadow of a doubt, consensus of the Sahaba. No such thing as taking the good and leaving the evil from the people of Bid'ah. You leave them completely and you do not approach them. Abdullah ibn Umar said about the Qadariyah, even though those individuals that came to him, they said to him that those people, that the place that we've come from in Iraq, that they possess some knowledge, but they have spoken and they deny the pre-decree of Allah. So Abdullah ibn Umar, he didn't say take knowledge from them and don't discuss pre-decree with them. He said, tell them and inform them that I am, that Abdullah ibn Umar is bari, that Abdullah ibn Umar is free and disassociates himself from them. And they are disassociated from me. No doubt whatsoever. Imam al-Sabuni, rahimahullahu ta'ala, in his Aqidatul Salaf wa Ashabul Hadith, that he mentions that it is forbidden by consensus to sit with the people of innovation. Rather, it is obligatory to despise them and to keep yourself away from them. Imam al-Baghawi, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he mentions that to keep away from Ahlul Bid'ah is something that is agreed upon without any difference of opinion. And those people who say that we will take the haq and will leave the evil, that I will sit with the people of truth and I will sit with the people of falsehood. Sufyan al-Thawri, he said, this person doesn't know truth from falsehood. When Layth ibn Sa'd, he said, that if I see a person, he said, wallahi, if I see a person of innovation, even if I see him walking on water, I wouldn't take knowledge from him. So he was said to Imam Shafi'i, this statement, he said, he has fallen short. Indeed, even if I saw him flying in the sky, I wouldn't take knowledge from him. But of course, if you think that you know better than the Salaf, then what can I do for you? I will take the good, leave the evil. Who cares about the Salaf? Then you're not Salaf. Then you're not upon the way of the Salaf and you've chosen your own misguidance. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, وَيَتَّبِعُ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَسِيرًا. And he chooses other than the path of the believers. And the believers have already told you, the Sahaba and those who came after them in righteousness, don't sit with them. But if you want to choose a path other than their path, then Allah leave you in the path that you've chosen. And we fear for you hellfire. We fear for you hellfire. You don't know good and you don't know evil. So how are you going to decipher between the two anyway? Muhammad ibn Sirin, some of the people of innovation came to Muhammad ibn Sirin. And they said to him, we wish to talk to you. He said, I don't want to talk to you. They said, let us then recite something from the book of Allah to you. He said, either you will get up and leave or I will get up and leave. Muhammad ibn Sirin didn't want to hear them. And what were they going to do? Recite the book of Allah. Is there any falsehood in the book of Allah? Nothing of falsehood in the book of Allah. He wouldn't even hear the book of Allah from them. And they say, oh, we want to go to these Maghrib Institute and take the good and leave the evil. There's no evil in the book of Allah, yet he's still Muhammad ibn Sirin, rahimahullah, died in the year 110 after the Hijrah. Met the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, from the best of the Sahaba he met them, Muhammad ibn Sirin. And yet Muhammad ibn Sirin, he didn't want to hear them recite the Quran to him. He said, they may twist it and he may enter my heart and cause it to deviate. So who are you?
How do you know the good that you think is good? Is good. It might be bad. And if you open that door like that to the awam, to the general public, then that means you take from anyone.
Take the good from all of them and leave the bad. Take the good from all of them and leave the bad. Take the good from all of them and leave the bad.